Dear friends, dear colleagues, dear dental makers, welcome back to the essential of digital dentistry. Welcome back to the Mangano Digital Academy. In this video, we will talk about 3D printing of dental implants in titanium. Yes, because it is something that we started to do around with Professor Carlo Mangano around 2006. We are keep doing this because it's a very innovative way to fabricate, to produce dental implants on a standardized way with a very peculiar geometry and a very peculiar mechanical characteristic and features. So in this case, we are talking about selective laser sintering and selective laser melting at the beginning in 2006 when we started. We adapted an EOS machine used for other purposes, for the automotive, for the aerospace industry. We adapted it for the medical industry. After 15 years, after 15 years, more or less, there are several companies producing machine for SLS, SLM for the medical and also for the dental field. Everything changed. So in this case, I could say that Carlo Mangano and Aldo Macchi were really pioneers of dentistry because they started with this project together with Professor Adriano Piattelli. The question here of this video is still, I think, up to date. Is can we print titanium dental implants? And here the first study published in Dental Material in 2008, and I think it was one of the first studies on direct laser metal sintering as a new approach for the fabrication of porous titanium dental implants, and one of the most cited study on my personal portfolio of publication, because it was super new, super innovative, and this was one of the first videos taken with the machine adapted for the fabrication of the titanium dental implants, and it worked so layer by layer. This machine was capable to fabricate the dental implants with a porous surface and a dense core, and with of course peculiar characteristics. Using the power of the laser, because basically this is the way 3D printing works. And but at that time in 2006 it was like something revolutionary and totally innovative. And I have to say that also now after 15 years only a few companies produce dental implants with these technologies, and obviously there are advantages and limitations. We should discuss about it. Anyway, this video explains how it worked, so, and how fast was the process and how innovative was the process of the fabrication of these implants. But let's go to the overall scheme, the overview, the idea behind the project, 3D printed titanium dental implants. We wanted to have a bone tissue engineering inspired dental implant, a fixture with a porous titanium surface with a 9-degree open interconnected porosity on the outer layer in order to help the bone to grow inside, and so to allow a mechanical interlocking between the implant and the bone, with pores that were consistent in geometry, in the shape, in order to have not only a bone on growth but a bone ingrowth, so a real osseoincorporation of the implant. And also it was possible, and it is possible, to attain a functionally graded structure with a lower model of elasticity compared to the implants that are available in the market, the milled ones, more similar to that of bone, in order to reduce the stress shielding. This is quite important in the medical field, for example, in some hip replacement, may be interesting, less in the dental field, but anyway, it's something that can be considered. Obviously, the core must be dense as possible in order to grant mechanical reliability. So these are the characteristics, more or less. And in this short video, we welcomed the new, digital dentist into a new era, the era of direct metal laser sintering, this innovative technology and additive manufacturing technology, used in this case to fabricate dental implants, a brand new method for the fabrication of titanium dental implants. And it works so, basically. Laser melting, a focused laser beam melt titanium powder layer by layer. And these are the characteristics of the scanning electron microscopy: a porous surface with an open interconnected structure of pores and cavities, several concavities outside, that allows the osseous incorporation, so not only bone on growth but also bone ingrowth, that grant mechanical over interlocking, and also an isoelastic surface, more similar to that of bone, at least to that of, to that of compact bone. But we have to say that the surface characteristic of this implant were very peculiar from the beginning when we watched the first one. This is the first publication, functionally graded titanium implants published in the Dental Materials in 2008. We found that the young modulus of the inner core material was 104 plus 7 gigapascal, with that of the outer porous material was 77 plus 3.5 gigapascal. And if compared to the one of bone, it's more similar to the one of bone than the elastic modulus of conventionally milled dental implants. But the point is more biological rather than mechanical, because this surface is very attractive for cells, and particularly for bone cells and for mesenchymal stem cells that are capable to commit into osteoblast, functional osteoblasts capable to produce matrix and so produce new bone. As in this paper published with Professor Rachel Sammons from the Birmingham University in the Journal of Biomedical Material Research in 2009. These features of the surface help the cells to express their osteogenic potential, basically. And they express their potential and we get the osseoincorporation. So if we watch these sections, we see that the bone is capable to grow and penetrate inside the cavities, inside the walls, interconnected with these tunnels, with this connection. And everything worked quite well. Here is another paper published with Professor Jamila Vachibli in the Journal of Biomedical Material Research in 2010. In humans, so we were able to demonstrate with human histology the perfect integration of these implants. And if we watch the literature starting from 2010 to 2020 more or less, we have also clinical studies on these implants. We have at least 10 clinical studies, and all of them are unfortunately short-term studies, even if we have some follow-up and the medium and term now. And the technology is the additive manufacturer of titanium. Here the list of studies. I have to say most of this study belong to our group, and here are a series of application of course of these implants, standardized implants for the in this case rehabilitation of a single tooth gap. They worked very well. If you look at the surface, it's an incredibly porous surface, but it goes under the bone, and then this porosity grant a very good also soft tissue healing, not only a very good hard tissue healing. And here the control after 2 years of this study published in 2012 with Michele De Franco, Carlo Mangano in the Lasers in Medical Science. Here a beautiful case of Dr. Paolo Mastrangelo published in the same paper. And several cases we made with single implants, also with bridges, and several applications, not only in fixed implant restoration, but also in removable implant restoration, like for example in this mandibular overdenture. 4 years of experience in this paper published in the Journal of Periodontology, very good results in terms of, implant survival and implant success rate and prosthetic success, also with this one-piece implant placed to support this mandibular overdenture. Obviously it's key not to go with a very very narrow diameter, because we need to consider that we have a porous surface outside that is something like 100 microns, so it's important to choose the proper diameters. Also in this case it worked very well also with external hexagon for maxillary overdentures, as we can see in this other study with Fabrizio Luongo, Jamil Shibli once again, and other authors for the maxillary overdentures. In this case, of course, the overdentures were supported by metal bars. And once again, these implants behaved very well in this 3-year prospective clinical study. We controlled 1 year, we controlled 3 years, everything worked very well, both in the maxilla and then in the mandible, as you can see, with different kind of restoration, fixed restoration and removable restoration. We are talking about short-term studies, unfortunately, but we are going to gather more, details along these years, and very soon we'll be able to publish a mid-term, at least a long, or maybe also a long-term study. These are also the application of DRAM metal laser sintering in titanium implants in healed and post-extractive sites. So also with the immediate implantation, the results can be very good in terms of aesthetic. As we can see here, these beautiful cases by my friend Dr. Paolo Mastrangelo at 3 years controlled, and the results were really excellent from the aesthetic point of view. So these implants, they can behave very well in both post-extractive and both healed site after 1, 2, 3 years, and sometimes it's very difficult to understand where the implant is because the restoration is very stable, from the aesthetic point of view, and pleasant along the time, at least in the short term. Also, when the implant is placed in post-extraction socket. This study was the biggest study we published on these implants, 103 patients with 3 years of follow-up, and it was a study on the aesthetics of immediately restored single implants placed in a extraction socket versus healed side of the anterior maxilla, so only the aesthetic area. And these cases were published in the Clinical Oral Implant Research in 2017. I hope we'll be able to update these results in a new study very soon, because we have a huge amount of data clinically, and definitely worth publication. So thank you very much for your kind attention.